The Office of the Auditor General has released the annual audit report for the financial year that ended June 2023, indicating that a huge imbalance in the national budget as expenditure budget exceeded revenue budget by 4.41 trillion shillings, while 5.8 trillion shillings was unutilized.
I noted that whereas the revenue budget was revised to 48.1 trillion, the expenditure budget was revised to a total of 52.5 trillion, which in the course of the year, leading to unbalanced budget of 4.4 trillion.
The Auditor General undertook a special audit of the salary payroll across government and established that 53 billion shillings was paid to ineligible staff who illegally accessed the government payroll. The Auditor General recommended for recovery of these funds and appropriate action to culpable staff.
Five, special audit on the government salary payroll. I undertook a special audit of the salary payroll across government, which included a validation of all government employees in 367 entities comprising of 162 MDAs, 176 local governments, and 29 other government organizations for the month of February 2023.
The report has also revealed that 5,619,120 COVID-19 vaccines valued at 28.159 billion shillings expired in the national medical stores, yet the vaccines were bought by a loan from the World Bank. The audit report has also revealed that five public universities in Uganda are teaching 222 expired courses, and these include Makerere University with 120, Chambogo University 63, Mbarara University 21 courses, MOBS 15 courses, and Gulu University 3 courses. The Auditor General has also revealed that Uganda's total public debt as of 30th June 2023 stood at 96.168 trillion shillings, comprising of domestic debt stock of 43.696 trillion shillings and external debt stock of 52.472 trillion shillings, with a report noting that Uganda's debt in 5 years from 2018 to 2019 has increased by 107%.
The total public debt as at 30th June 2023 stood at 96.1 trillion, comprising of domestic stock of 43.6 trillion and external debt stock of 52.4 trillion. This represents an increase of 9.3 trillion, equivalent to 10% compared to 86.8 trillion that was reported in 30th June 2022.
It has been revealed that 604 beneficiaries of the Parish Women Model Program from 242 PDM circles implemented ineligibility projects, while 53 beneficiaries in the 44 PDM circles had non-existent projects. Government lost 52.2 billion shillings due to inability to collect taxes from gold exports, while 9.7 billion shillings was lost due to backdated e-portal inspection records at UNBS. Upon receiving the report, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, tasked the Leader of Opposition to ensure timely scrutiny of the audit reports.
Because these reports are for the Leader of Opposition, he's supposed to check government on what has been done, and I'm very happy with your findings. And I want to request you, Leader of Opposition, that we are going to hand over these reports to you today, and we pray that we receive reports back within the 6 months.
Among asked government to stop transferring officials implicated in corruption, but instead retire them in public interest.
If somebody has made a mistake, let's bring the person to book. Not just transferring vices from one area to the other.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.